Well, cue the fire. The Biden administration is in emergency mode as a city, and not just a city. Many cities are on the brink of collapse.
The Chicago PMI has unexpectedly plummeted to levels reminiscent of some of the most severe economic downturns in history.
Major cities across the U.S. are in financial trouble.
I think we can all agree on that we're broke.
To benefit the middle class and grow the economy.
Finding nearly 80% of Americans now view fast food as a luxury.
Because this mentality is going to destroy this country.
And as I said to you on Friday, we have cities that are in depression. For some reason, it's unexpectedly. And it's not just cities, it is the entire world. The fastest declining economies. Countries from around the world are doing everything that they can to survive. Japan confirms it spent $62 billion. They are selling bonds like never before, and this always happens at market tops right before recessions. Sell bonds, receive dollars, buy yen. And the same thing with China. China dumps 101 with a lot of commas, treasuries, and then what do they receive? They receive dollars, and then what do they do with that? They try to save their economy, but it will fail. If you're like, well, I don't care about China, I don't care about Japan, I care about United States of America, it is fallen. You're like, and I know stores are like, okay, we got it, we're just gonna lock up everything, you can't buy anything, it's all behind plastic. All you have to do now, I'm not saying to do this, they're bringing blow torches in and grabbing everything. Yep. You could still loot. And what are the consequences? Well, basically, absolutely nothing. And it continues. And now in major cities, your stores are now gone. They've said, F it, we're out. And it's cities like New York, Chicago, Los Angeles. It's all cities. Oh, and just FYI, all of these cities that are collapsing and falling, they don't have money. Look, cities that did not have enough money to pay their bills. All of them. What are all these cities gonna do to solve all of this? All businesses are leaving, people are leaving. Well, California considers charging drivers by the mile. Now, I don't know if it's 30 cents or it's $3, but they'll start with something low and then, like with always, it goes up. I mean, I doubt if they will be brazen enough to hit you with 30 cents a mile. It'll start low. And it'll probably get to a point where you will be too broke to even drive out of California. So ladies and gentlemen, boys and squirrels, the moment you've been waiting for, we're all gonna die. Yes, in the last 3 years, this administration, whether it's this administration, the other administration, has been able to destroy America. And if you think it's bad now, it's only gonna get worse as the elites are like, is he in jail yet? Because we need to finish what we started. And where do I even start? You want to start with the 15 fastest declining economies in the world, or you want to take a look here? As everyone unexpectedly enters recessions, and more close to home, depressions. Chicago depressionary levels. And I like how Michael always writes, it's probably nothing. Probably you don't understand, the market kind of went up on Friday as CTAs, I told you this. They had to reposition. Friday was it. Now, good luck for June. U.S. money supply is doing something so scarce that it hasn't happened since the Great Depression. So that's, we're going back, we have to go back to 1929 of how everything is currently set up. And then we got to go back to the 1800s, 1870 to be more specific. It has to do with money. It has to do with a dollar shortage, meaning it is going away. That's why other countries are panicking. That's why we are panicking. That is why we are going to go into a recession, and there is a high probability of a depression, which some states, they're already feeling it. Bravo, we come here because of the stock market. We want to know which way the stock market's going to go. Well, I can show you some charts that show a possibility, a probability of a 60% drop in the NASDAQ. But Bravo, we're good right now. It's called a market top. This is how it always is. And I told you way back, I'm like, okay, we're going to bounce. We're going to go really high. Everyone's going to front run the Fed. Go back in my videos, a year, 2 years. It's like, it's the same patterns. And it kind of looks like this. It's the same thing that happens every single time. But in this time around, it probably went like that, and then like that. Which would also be considered a close to, if not exactly on, a double top. But I will trade it all the way up and all the way down, and I won't look like that. When the market goes down, your portfolio is going up. The last time this measure was this high, The Great Recession was just a few months away. Well, hey, look, things like, can we just hold this together for 5 more months, 6 more months? No, sir, you only have about one. What I think is more important than this article from investing.com was actually a comment. How are you feeling? What's going on? I owned a house for 30 years. 10 years ago, I moved overseas and I have just returned. Welcome back. I can't find an affordable house, home to buy, or even an apartment to rent. I am living in my car. The United States of America is spiraling downward like a toilet being flushed. Soon there will be nothing left. But what you need to understand, it is not about you. It's never been about you. It's about the elites and the 0%. Let me tell you, for them, it has never been better. Not just that, we're only in the third inning, right? Have you seen all of the banks fail yet? Nope, they're coming. JP Morgan Chase CEO warns extraordinary government spending, which you just saw Janet, will. It's not maybe. It will trigger a major economic fallout. I mean, when you have JP Morgan Chase CEO Jamie Dimon issues a major warning on where he believes the US economy is headed, you should probably listen. Well, it's good for him because he's like, I told you so. See, now I have to take over all of these banks. Gosh, how are these major banks doing? Well, here's JP Morgan looking great above the 200. Also, correction. Yesterday, I received emails, comments about how whales actually live. And I may have said they come up for water. They come up for air, right? And then they go down. And me being a surfer, I've tried to make my indicators like surfing. Also, when the whale alert pops up on the screen, it's a big deal. I have also spent months and months and months with the development team on a few more things that are coming out at the end of the year, where you will receive things on the screen, your phone will go off, but it's only when you can't miss this one. I'm also going to allow, I'll say beta testers, because I don't want to roll it out to everyone, and you'll get 50% off. I could be wrong. Link in the description, 50% off of all of my indicators, along with everything that I am going to include at the end of the year, like my whale alerts, my alerts, all the other kit and caboodles that I am going to throw in there. Also, if I head over to Chart Prime and I see all my stuff, the special edition, there's gonna be a clock, and I think they give you 24 hours, maybe 1 hour, I don't know. Grab it. My goal is to make this the best experience, trading experience you've ever had, along with, if you guys ever question, click the little chat. They come up and they'll help you. You're like, but I already have all the indicators. If you want, you can go to the chat and say, I have it. It's because I'm testing it. And if I screw it up, I only want to screw it up for a few people, then you can go, it's okay, I forgive you. You gave me big discounts, so I like you. I also forgot to remove my Memorial Day sale. So, okay, why don't we throw that one in? That's 80% off any course. Start with my swing trading. Look at that, just on this, oh my golly. I mean, I could measure it, but I already know. It's probably 18%. What do we got? We got 16% there, 7, 8, 9, swing trade. That's the 200, that's the Bravo 9. What are you making? If you were to come in here, right there, right at that whale, 9, 27%. Your portfolio go up. Start with my bull market course, then my bear market course, because you gotta make money up and down. Also, if you are just an investor, just click subscribe. I'll give you the big here, do this when you come to the channel. Which sometimes it's on my watch list, sometimes not. Actually, you're not gonna find seasonality, but okay, crude oil. You guys ready for this? All right, these are my big money subscribers. What month are we? We're in June, seasonality down, okay? You wanna see market go up? July, August, September, October, okay? Crude oil go up. And now I could already hear the emails ringing. How do I trade crude oil? What do I do? Okay, because you don't want to trade charts. You're just like, just tell me what to do. And just FYI, that is a terrible way to move money. I'm just saying. Here, this is where it's at. It's right above my hair. See, same color, orange. XOM, XOP. All right, let's go with Exxon, which had a run up, 9 count down, 9 count, run up, 9 count, false, which is extremely bullish, flag pole. Do you see this right here? Woo! Get a ready. Oil should shoot through the roof and you should take profit. Because after shoot through roof, come back floor. Also, if you just took my swing trading course, you will not understand what this is. It doesn't it look like a flag? I actually learned this in my bear market course. That's where I teach you patterns. I do what's called scaffolding. That's what we do as teachers. We have to build. That's why I started the courses off with swing trade, very basic, then bear market, then crypto, and then options. And when I was in my swing trade, I'm like, never leverage, right? And then options, I'm like, let's go, baby. Because you weren't ready for it. Then when you put this all together, digits go up. But if you don't do anything, then digits go down. Welcome to inflation. Welcome to the loss of everything. Welcome to, you can't keep up. You move away, you come back, and you're like, what the hell just happened? As the backbone of America, the economy was just dealt a serious blow. Not just one, we got a lot of blows. This is like Hollywood and Vine. We all saw this coming a year ago, 2 years ago. I'm like, look at China, watch China. 6 months ago, when everyone's like, wait until they reopen, blah, blah, blah. I'm like, ah, that's not really working. That rolls, we are the ones who purchase from them, and China factory activity shrinks. Surprise, hit to growth outlook. They have no growth, it is gone. They are crying in the streets. They're like, please, America, buy our plastic things. And we're like, we don't have any money. Because all over America, everything is slowing, grinding to a halt. Or as they say, US economy cooled. And GDP was revised down. Everyone is leaving the cities. It's just very nice. It's okay. We're just gonna go. As billionaire CEO, real estate investor, on impact of Trump verdict, that went over real well for the Democrats. Quote, nobody wants to do business in New York, in California, in Chicago, in any cities. Bye-bye. Oh, and something I need to explain that I explained at the beginning, but I will do it again, has to do with the rest of the world. They're selling U.S. treasuries. Now, all of my gold friends, which I've had them all on channels before, silver friends, it's okay. We can all be friends here. Most people are going to take this and go, you see, everyone's ditching the dollar. The dollar's dead. Well, go take a look at the DXY and tell me if it's dead. I'm going to go with bet you're above the 200. I'm going to go with I bet you bounced on a trend line. And I'm also going to go with don't be shocked if it destroys the entire world. Now, top yen forecaster sees currency sliding to the lowest since 1986. The worlds are panicking. They're dumping U.S. bonds. Oh no, what do they do after they sell? Oh, they get dollars. And then what do they do with the dollars? They prop up their currency because they're dying. And I've done videos in the past where you're looking at it and they're trying to chop it down, beat it down. They can't do it. Every time you see this happening, we go into recessions. We're in it, right? But they won't say it. China dumps a lot of commas. U.S. treasuries in 12 months. Fed governor dismisses, right? Oh, demise of the dollar. That's what everyone will say. But then everyone doesn't understand why? Why you dump said dollar? That's because they're not dumping the dollar. They're selling their treasury bonds. It's an emergency. If you sell yours, it's an emergency. And then you receive what? Dollars. And I'm actually looking for the chart that I actually went through decades of when did they dump and what happened to your stock market after. By the way, S&P 500, you're in a rising wedge. Bullish or bearish? That's bearish, market go down. But not yet, you gotta break that white line. See that white line right there? Oh, and I found the chart for you. Here's S&P 500, SPX. That's a left shoulder head, right shoulder. Price target, I don't know if we're gonna make it. 5,700, all right. Every time they dump, here we go. There's one, market sold off, all right. There's two, and they do it ahead of time. That's because it's getting bad. It's gonna get bad. Hold on, I got more notes. Oh, Fed rate cuts, there, right there, dump. Now, they could be dumping, you're like, you said the market's gonna go down, and it has not gone down yet. Any more drawings from Bravo? Oh, I got another one for you. That was a pretty good one. And my apologies for going back in time and showing you that, but I need you to understand. Because I don't have gold and silver to sell you, even though you can buy as much as you want. Going to buy low, sell high, buy low, sell high. People hate me when I do it for my crypto, my gold, my silver, but stocks, that's okay. Bonds, that's fine. Guys, all I'm trying to do is make digits go up so I can live the life I want. Because as you know, life passes very quickly. And that's what I'm trying to help you. Let's have a good one. Get out of the cities. And you know how, do as I say, not as I actually do these things, even though I get heat. But that's okay. You still love me. I still love you. And I'll see you tomorrow.